Who was the first person to go round the world in 80 days?
Turn right.
Yeah. Michael Palin.
It's a real person. I'm not counting fictional. In the fiction, of course, it's
Phileas Fogg.
It was Phileas Fogg, yeah.
Blue whale.
First person was very much in the question. But so, it's interesting I said first person. Because, in fact, it was a woman.
Amy Johnson?
It was, show that again in the audience. Nellie Bly. Well done, audience member. Nellie Bly is the right one.
Nellie Bly?
Yes. Very impressed indeed. And I think Nellie Bly is someone we all should have heard of, because she's a very remarkable woman. She was possibly the world's first investigative journalist. She was a remarkably bold, brave and adventurous woman. Yeah. She worked for The World, which was Joseph Pulitzer's newspaper. In 1890, after the astonishing success of Jules Verne's novel Round the World in 80 Days, Joseph Pulitzer decided that he would try and get someone genuinely to go round the world in 80 days, which hadn't been done yet. And he awarded the role to one of his journalists. And Nellie Bly said, basically, if you don't give me the task, I will leave the world and go to another newspaper. And so valued was she that he said, well, OK, you've got the job. And she did it in 72 days, which is pretty damned impressive. In those days, in the 1890s, before aeroplanes, obviously, getting from one place all the way around the globe to another in that amount of time was a heck of an achievement.
It took a bloody long time to get from Scotland to London in those
days. Well, quite, exactly. Can you remember in the book the sorts of forms of travel Phileas Fogg used?
There were some trains going on, weren't there?
Trains, yes.
There were some hot air balloons.
Not hot air balloons. Oh. That's the bizarre thing.
Just had a balloon on the
screen. I know, because of the film. In the film, the Michael Todd film, David Niven, one always thinks of the balloon, but in fact, in the book, he doesn't use a balloon. Anyway, she did it in 72 days, 6 hours and 11 minutes from New York to New York. Grand parade. But maybe she should be better remembered for her campaigns against bad landlords, injustice, injustice to women in prisons, and most amazingly, she also managed to smuggle herself into an insane asylum and wrote an extraordinary report about the unbelievable cruelty that was dealt to the mentally ill in New York.
Well, I think that's a more extraordinary story than you know. It sounds to me like she managed to talk her way out of an insane asylum.
Well, with a story
about being an investigative journalist.
Well, that is genius.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Please, come on, pick something.